हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अगेन हियर विथ माय न्यू वीडियो, द सेम टॉपिक फोर्स एंड प्रेशर. एज यू नो इट्स अ वेरी बिग टॉपिक, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज टेकिंग सो मच टाइम. इट्स अ टॉपिक फोर्स एंड प्रेशर एंड वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग प्रेशर एग्जर्टेड बाय एटमोसफेयर, एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, what is atmospheric pressure? We have already discussed. Now come to this. This pressure is so great. This is a great pressure, very high pressure. This pressure is so great that it can crush our body. It can crush our body. But it is balanced by the blood pressure acting from inside. So this pressure is, atmospheric pressure is so much high that it can crush our body, but our internal blood pressure cancels this outer pressure. That's why we are safe. Now a few points are there. This pressure is maximum at the sea level. At the sea level, this is maximum. This pressure is minimum at high mountains. As you will go up high mountains, the atmospheric pressure decreases. The reason is this pressure decreases at high altitudes. At high altitudes it decreases, as you will go down it increases. That's why it is maximum at sea level and minimum at high mountains. Now some applications related to this atmospheric pressure. Number one, nose bleeding at high altitudes. If you will go high mountains, at high altitudes, you find that your nose start bleeding. It is due to atmospheric pressure. As I have told you, as you will go high altitudes, the atmospheric pressure decreases. So if it will decrease, then your internal body pressure will increase and it will force to nose bleeding. Now come to second one. We used to drink through a straw. As we used to drink something with the help of a straw, it is due to atmospheric pressure. Go through this figure. This arrow indicating atmospheric pressure. Due to pressure, it rises in the straw. And we used to drink something with the help of a straw. Three, working of rubber air sucker. Rubber air sucker, you have seen. If you will fix in the wall, it is fixed in the wall without any pasting materials, it will lead to atmospheric pressure. Working of a parachute. You have seen the parachute when it is coming down due to atmospheric pressure. It is balanced in the air. Working of a dropper. You can see there is a dropper. If you want to take some liquid in dropper, it is due to atmospheric pressure, it is possible. Just like this, this is also, you can see with the help of arrow, atmospheric pressure is applied in both the cases and liquid rises in the dropper and air rises in the straw. So in these two cases, you can see, go through the figure. So here I have written five examples related to some applications related to atmospheric pressure. You have to try find out more pressures. Now some facts related to this force and pressure chapter. Up to here I think this chapter is complete, but few facts are there you should go through. Number one, facts related to the topic, to this topic. Number one, if two forces act together from opposite directions and no motion is there, called balanced force. Can remember balanced and unbalanced force, this part we have left. So here go through this figure. There is a trolley, from opposite sides two persons is trying to push it by applying forces, two forces in opposite direction. If there is no motion, no motion means it is a balanced force. Both the forces are equal. F1, force F1 applied by first person, F2 applied by second person. Both are equal. It means there is no motion and this is a balanced force. So balanced force means there is no motion, but forces are applied. Now second one, if there is motion in the direction of greater force called unbalanced force. Unbalanced force, you can see, go through this figure. Trolley is there, two persons are applying force from opposite directions, F1 and F2, and there is a motion. If there is a motion, so there may be two reasons of the motion. Either F1 first force applied by first person is greater, then trolley will move in the same direction of the bigger force. And if F2 is bigger, the second force is bigger, then it will move in this direction, in the direction of applied force. In both the cases, this is a unbalanced force. So balanced force and unbalanced force. Balanced force, no motion. Unbalanced force, there is a motion. Now come to here. Device used to measure pressure is called barometer. We have learned about pressure this chapter. We have to measure the pressure. The local pressure is measured by barometer. Barometer is a device. One more device is there, that is called manometer. So manometer is device used to measure any type of pressure. So barometer and manometer both are used to measure the pressure. But the main difference is all the barometers are manometers. It means manometer is the bigger one. It has many uses. It can be used to measure any type of pressure. Pressure exerted by air, pressure exerted by gases, pressure exerted by water. Anything that can be measured by using manometer. And barometer is used to measure the air pressure, pressure around us. Now all barometers are manometers, and figure is already there. Go through the figures. So on the whole, what was left, I have discussed. One more time, atmospheric pressure, here written. Applications, few applications I have written. You can also find more applications. And the figures, go through the figure, the use of atmospheric pressure. And then some facts are there. The facts are balanced and unbalanced force. With the help of these two figures, you can understand barometer, manometer. And after this, I will come in my next video with some numericals, some assignments related to the complete chapter, this complete topic, force and pressure. So be ready for assignment that I will give you related to this chapter. Till then, continue. Goodbye. But before that, I will give you a few seconds to note down all these materials in your notebook. You can also pause the video and you can note down all these written parts. It is very much clear. And if any doubt or query, we will discuss later on. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.